Let's set this video back to the late 60s. It was a time of discontent with the establishment. Footage of the atrocities from the Vietnam War were broadcasted to televisions around the globe. A generation grew desensitized to violence by footage presented by the establishment. The rebels were ripening. The studios verged collapse. The producers were out of touch. In comes a new Hollywood, financed through exploitation and directed towards difficult ideas. The commercial auteurs were released from the shackles of the motion picture production code. Scorsese was one of these film authors, well-versed to the language of both Hollywood and world cinema. Scorsese proves to be a film auteur in that he has a myriad of themes that he likes to explore throughout his filmography, such as religion, violence, and masculinity. The European and world cinema was a huge influence on the young Scorsese, as they were tackling touchy subjects that the studios were afraid to produce because of the code. These edgy films were able to pull in young audiences who were no longer interested in the big song and dance films that the studios had become accustomed to producing. So the studios decided to allocate small budgets to these newly graduated film school artists, who left behind the sound studios and created these small budget, small crew films, often with close mates. However, the new Hollywood authors didn't have all to say. Studio executives still demanded that their films be commercially viable and appeal to a wider American audience. So commercial auteurs like Scorsese used exploitative techniques to bring in the audiences to the cinema to make a return on investment for the studios, while also satisfying their artistic desire to explore alternative ideas and themes. Scorsese does this in a bohemian way that does not conform to the traditional values that were existent in 20th century film. In Scorsese's 1976 classic Taxi Driver, set in a seemingly lawless New York City, Robert De Niro plays a character, Travis Bickle, who represents a recurring character in Scorsese's films, a complicated dark hero with conviction. This also leads into religious themes that Scorsese is infatuated with. For example, in this scene when Travis says,
"All the animals come out at night. Whores, skunk pussies, buggers, queens, fairies, dopers, junkies. Sick, venal. Someday a real rain will come and wash all the scum off the streets."
The rain represents the holy water that is used in Catholic baptism, which symbolizes the cleansing of sin. Whereas in Scorsese's film Mean Streets from 1973, the main character played by Harvey Keitel, Charlie, portrays a character somewhat akin to Jesus in that he is a savior, a central figure surrounded by people who sin. However, Scorsese challenges the religious norm when Charlie says,
"If I do something wrong, I just want to pay for it my way. So I do my own penance for my own sins. What do you say, huh?"
"That's all bullshit except the pain, right? The pain of hell. The burn from a lighted match increased a million times.
Infinite.
No, you don't fuck around with the infinite. There's no way you do that. Pain in hell has two sides. The kind you can touch with your hand. The kind you can feel in your heart. Your soul, the spiritual side. And you know, the worst of the two is the spiritual."
Charlie is seen throughout the film to continually bear the pain of the flame. His increasing tolerance of the flame throughout the film suggests that his soul has been withered and or contemplates whether he is in fact already in hell. Blood can serve as powerful imagery in religious messaging, and Scorsese relates blood to redemption, as shown in the final scene of Taxi Driver, when he rescues Iris, played by Jodie Foster, who plays a 12-year-old prostitute who's controlled by a pimp. After Travis Bickle's heroic act, the shedding of his blood reflects the shedding of his sins.
"There's no escape. God's a lonely man."
The coupling of redemption and blood is also used in Raging Bull. The main protagonist, Jake, also encourages his opponents to cut up his face, which suggests that he wishes to atone for his terrible sins, that being his domestic violence he inflicted on his wife and brother. Here, Jake is crucified on the rope of the ring. The climactic end sequence of Mean Streets includes admission of Charlie's guilt, religious pouring of holy water, and the shedding of sinful blood.
I guess you could safely say that things haven't gone so well tonight. But I'm trying, Lord, I'm trying.
It was common for these new Hollywood films to enter in the lives of criminals, such as Bonnie and Clyde, to explore the challenges that everyone faces in life, no matter which side of the law that you stand on, such as jealousy, loneliness, and money.
What's the matter? You too good for this $10, huh? You too good for it. It's a good $10.
Throughout Raging Bull, Jake's increasing paranoia about his wife cheating on him was correlated with the rising amount of violence in the household. The thought of Vicky pleasuring another man emasculates Jake, triggering violent outbursts. The indefensible violence exerted by the character was extremely graphic for the time. This hurt the film commercially in initial box office sales, but the documentary-style filmmaking is central to Scorsese's authorship. He finds it difficult to tell a fantasy story, as he's more fascinated with the truth. A great example of the push and pull of the auteur and its commercial environment. After Travis's failed attempt at starting a relationship with Betsy, and his frustration over his inability to protect Iris, leads Travis to begin collecting these phallic objects which function to strengthen his masculinity. In the final scenes of Raging Bull, Jake surrounds himself with phallic symbols, such as the Tower of Champagne and his cigar, in an attempt to reassert his fading masculinity. To sum up, Martin Scorsese epitomizes the term commercial auteur. His filmography embodies persistent themes and filmic techniques, true of a film author, schooled in world cinema, who has experienced both box office glory and misfortune, within and without the studio system. Here is a list of all the films included in this video and the research conducted for this essay.